بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك اللهم يا مقلب القلوب والأبصار ثبت قلوبنا على دينك بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم today inshallah we will be talking about several surahs so we will be starting, inshallah, with Surah Al-Dhuha. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. We know that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam started with the da'wah, calling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 3 years in secret. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered him to go in public. So, Quraysh started to oppose Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to belie him and to torture his companions. And subhanallah, at one time the wahi, the revelation, stopped. And here the non-believers said, okay, you see, this is a sign that Jibreel is not coming down with any new revelation. So his Lord has abandoned him and he is no more loved by his Lord. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this surah. And this surah, with it, it starts with a swear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it starts with an oath. Allah is swearing by time. He's swearing by al-duha. He's swearing by al-layl. So what's the importance of this? We see that, we said that there was an interval in which Jibreel stopped revealing any Quran to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam thought that Allah might not be pleased with him for something that he has done. Or he was so worried, why, what happened, why the revelation stopped. So this, the theme of this surah is to console Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the object is to remove the anxiety and the distress that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had because of the suspension of revelation. So the surah starts with wadduha. It's an oath by time. Wallayli idha saja. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he is swearing by the forenoon full of light and by the night when it darkens. Allah is swearing by time. He's swearing about what? مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى. Your Lord has neither abandoned you, nor he hates you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, he has not forsaken you, nor he is displeased with you, as what the mushrikeen are claiming. وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. So the akhirah, indeed the hereafter, is better for you than the present. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to sleep on a straw mat. One day he woke up and it left a mark on his body. So his companion said, Ya Rasulullah, how will you allow us to prepare something softer for you, softer than this straw mat? And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why would I care about this dunya? So مالي وللدنيا إنما مثلي ومثل الدنيا كراكب ظل تحت ظل شجرة ثم راح وتركها. I am like someone who is moving, who is traveling along the way, and he got tired. He sat down under the shade of a tree. He rested, then he went on again. So he is not caring about dunya. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى. The hereafter is better for you than the present. وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Verily, your Lord will give you so much that you shall be well pleased. So don't pay attention to what they are saying. Allah has prepared for you what pleases you. In the day after, Allah will please Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what pleases Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the most is his ummah. He was always worried about his ummah, and Sayyidina Muhammad and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised him that لَن نَسُؤْكَ فِي أُمَّتِكَ. We will not let you down. We will make you pleased. We will please you with your ummah. So Allah has prepared a lot for Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He prepared the river of Kawthar with pearls on its banks. The mud of this river on its banks is the strongest fragments of musk. Subhanallah. So this is just one thing. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to Sayyidina Muhammad, أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى. Did he not find you an orphan and gave you shelter? So, you know, his father died while he was while his mother was still pregnant with him. And his mom died when he was six. He was under the guardianship of his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib. When his grandfather died, it was the age of eight, so his uncle Abu Talib continued to take responsibility. He continued to protect him, to assist him, to honor him, to restrain people from harming him. So all that was أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى. You were an orphan, but you were sheltered. So وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا فَهَدَى. And he found you looking for the truth, and he guided you. We know that the Quraysh used to worship idols, but Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never did. So he used to go to the cave, just to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to contemplate, to look for the truth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided him. وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا فَهَدَى. So the word ضَالًّا is looking for the truth. وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى. And he found you poor and made you rich. So in his childhood, he was poor, but he was blessed. When he was at the house of his uncle, when they used to serve the food, if anyone starts the food before him, the food will not suffice everybody. But his uncle noticed that when Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to start the food, then it will be enough for everybody and there will be leftovers. So this was one of his richness, that he was blessed. Another thing, he was successful also. When he went for trading for Sayyida Khadija radiallahu anha, he got back with so much wealth, with so much benefit. So wealth is described by Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, لَيْسَ الْغِنَى عَنْ كَثْرَةِ الْعَرَبِ وَلَكِنَّ الْغِنَى غِنَى النَّفْسِ. Wealth is not determined by abundance of possessions, but wealth is the richness of the soul. There are so many poor people, but you feel that they are the happiest people on earth because they are close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They know the taste of what it means. They know the taste of being close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they don't care about this trivial dunya. وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ. Therefore, do not be harsh on the orphans. Do not treat orphans with oppression. So treat them with kindness. Treat them with good manners. Be a counsel to them that they lost their one of their parents. So be good to them. Make them forget what they lost. Make them live, be able to live happily. وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَى. And do not put down the one who asks. And asking can be in two different things. So the first one, someone might ask for help for because of poverty, he would ask for anything. Or someone might ask you for knowledge. And beware of keeping knowledge to yourself if you know it. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows that it's not easy to spread knowledge. So he says, خَاطِبُ النَّاسَ عَلَىٰ قَدْرِ عُقُولِهَا. Talk to people according to their way of understanding. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. And proclaim the grace of your Lord. Thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all his bounties. Thank him for your hearing. Thank him for your eyesight. Thank him for the ability to walk. Thank him for creating lovely sceneries around you. Thank him for rain. Thank him for wind. Thank him for everything. And the best way to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to thank him for giving you good health, is to pray two rak'ahs of duha every day. Duha prayer is a sunnah, and its time starts after 10-15 minutes after sun rises until 10-15 minutes before Dhuhr prayer. Before Adhan prayer, not Dhuhr prayer, before Adhan prayer. So do just two rak'ahs to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings that He has given you. And we cannot thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We cannot thank Him enough. So we say, Allahumma la uhsi thana'an alayka anta kama asnayta ala nafsik. I cannot praise you the way you deserve, Ya Allah. So once the angels have catalog, if someone does this good thing, then you write so much and so much of good deeds for him. If someone does this, you write this amount of good deeds. Once they heard a slave of Allah saying, Ya Rabbi, laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa azimi sultanik. Thanks is for you, Allah. Thanks that is suitable to the grace of your face and the greatness of your supreme authority. Ya Rabbi, laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa azimi sultanik. So they asked Allah, Ya Allah, we don't have this, we don't know how much good deeds to write for him. And Allah said, write it as is, and I will reward him for this in the day after. Ya Rabbi, laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhika wa azimi sultanik. One of the highest forms of thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, I prepared something. I don't know if I can share my screen with you. Okay, so I prepared this. So Surah ad-Dhuha, Surah ad-Dhuha, there is another way of reading Surah ad-Dhuha, and this is the only surah in the Quran that we can read it in two different ways. So we the first ayah and the second, wal-duha wal-layli idha sajra, these are the oath. We will start from the ayah after. مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَىٰ. And I'm going from right to left, same way as we write in Arabic. مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَىٰ. And then, we write the second ayah, وَلَا الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى. Then go down and write the next three ayahs on the second line. And on the third line, write the last three ayahs. And the secret is read the column by column. So if we read, مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَلَى أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى فَأَمَّا الْيَتِيمَ فَلَا تَقْهَرْ. So your Lord neither abandoned you nor he hates you. Then, did he not find you an orphan and gave you shelter? Therefore, do not be harsh to the orphan. If we move to the second column, we read, وَلَلْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الْأُولَى وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًّا فَهَدَى وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرْ. Indeed, the hereafter is better for you than the present. He found you looking for the truth and guided you. Do not put down the one who asks and the one who wants to learn about the truth. The last column, وَلَسَوْفَ يُعْطِيكَ رَبُّكَ فَتَرْضَى وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. Verily your Lord will give you so much that you shall be pleased, well pleased. And he found you poor and made you rich. And proclaim the grace of your Lord. So if you think of the way column-wise, it will be amazing meaning. And this is the only surah in the Quran that you can write it like this and understand it in a very nice way. Okay, so Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Let's go back. Okay, now we move, inshallah, to Surah Ash-Sharh. And we all know the story of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he was young, the two angels who came and they opened his chest, they took the portion of shaitan from his chest, and so on. We know this story. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ. Haven't we illuminated your heart? Haven't we expanded your heart? Allah has taken care of the heart of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There is no way for shaitan to be in there. And it's wide enough to grasp and to understand the risala, the message, and to spread it to people. وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ. We took care of the burden of delivering the mission, of delivering the message. So Allah, when you see a father working day and night just to provide for his children because he loves them, well, just think of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loves all his ummah. And he was the one who would leave his pulpit of light on the day of judgment and go wandering and begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive his ummah and to make sure that his ummah, none of his ummah, none of the Muslims would stay in Jahannam. He would take the records and go and argue. He will do his best so that he will have his ummah saved. This was a burden for him. وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ الَّذِي أَنْقَضَ ظَهْرَكَ. So this weighed heavy upon you. So we removed from you the heavy burden that was weighing your back. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. We have raised high your fame and your name. How did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do that? First of all, in adhan, when we say أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put his name with the name of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with his name. So this is the first step for a person to be a Muslim. He would mention the name of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he mentions the name of Allah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put his name with the name of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on the arsh. So when Adam alayhi salam asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness after he ate from the tree, he said, Ya Allah, I ask you to forgive me with the blessings of Muhammad. And Allah asked him, how do you know about Muhammad? He said, hasn't he been so loved to you and so special to you? You wouldn't have written his name with your name on the arsh. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. So Allah has raised high the name of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was 1440 years back, but his name is mentioned today and will stay mentioned till the day after, till the end of the dunya. And when it's the day after, the paradise will not be open unless Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam opens its doors. فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Verily, along with every hardship is relief. With difficulty there is ease. So this means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you victory. إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. And verily, with difficulty there is relief. So this is reaffirming by repeating that Allah will give victory to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you look at the word al-usr, you find that it starts with al. Al is equals the in English. It's a definite article. So we are talking about something definite, about one thing. But if you look at the word yusra, it doesn't have al at the beginning. So ease is not counted. It's not just one thing. It's all the type of ease. إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith for فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا that وَلَنْ يَغْلِبَ عُسْرٌ يُسْرَيْن. So the عُسْر, which is one, will not conquer or will not overcome two users, which are uncountable. فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ. So now, this is a message for everyone. When you are done with your worldly affairs and its tasks, then devote yourself to Allah's worship. فَانْصَبْ. Stay with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do your prayers. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَرْغَبْ. And turn your attention to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you too take time to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the best time to be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the time before Fajr prayer, where everyone is sleeping, where you have time that will not be, nothing will cause you to be away from enjoying this time with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are alone with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَلَا يُحِبُّ كُلُّ حَبِيبٍ أَنْ يَخْلُو بِحَبِيبِهِ. Doesn't everyone like to be alone with with the one whom he loves? So take the advantage of this time. Now we move to Surah At-Tin. Surah At-Tin talks about the places where revelation started, where revelation happened. So what are these revelations. What theme? We will be talking about the places here. So Allah, when we start with the ayah with waw, we said that this is an oath. So Allah is swearing by the places where revelation was revealed, was descended. So watini wa zaytun, what is the place, what is the teen, the fig and the olives has to do with places? Take the place where they are highly produced, where they are planted. A teen is way produced in, you can get it in Bilad al-Sham, which is Lebanon, Syria, Palestine, and Jordan. As zaytun, the best place to give zaytun is Jerusalem and Palestine. So these are sacred places that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing with. Now, if you would take the fruit thingy, the fruit and the food item in this ayah, watini wa zaytun, we find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I heard this once from Sheikh Khatri. Someone told me that Sheikh Khatri said it. Watini wa zaytun. So Allah started with a teen and followed it by zaytun. So teen is better than the zaytun. How? First of all, it's sweet. It's delicious. It is, you can eat it all. You don't throw anything off a fig. So the fig is better than zaytun. Zaytun, if you just pick up a pluck of zaytuna, one olive, and eat it, it's so you can't swallow it. So this is the taste thing. And you throw the pit of the zaytun, of the olives. So the teen is better than the zaytun. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, also, he is swearing by a teen because of its importance. Earlier, when Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam was naked because he ate the hada, from the tree, then he used to cover his parts, his private parts, with the leaves of the figs. Also, teen is important, zaytun is important now, when it was at the time of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam, and they were on the ship, so there was the flood. Allah sent a bird, and he had a piece of zaytun leaf. Just a small piece. So that gave the idea for Sayyidina Nuh that the flooding is getting is calming down, and that they are close to earth. Now the water is going to recede. So teen and zaytun are important. Waturi sinin. And by the Mount of Sinai, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the mount which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa alayhi salam. So this is a sacred place also. وَهَذَا الْبَلَدِ الْأَمِينَ. هَذَا الْبَلَدِ الْأَمِينَ. And by this city of peace. This city of peace is Makkah al-Mukarramah, where Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born. So Makkah was honored because Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was born in it. And revelation started in Mecca. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says when he conquered Mecca, whoever enters Mecca is safe. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. Verily, we created man in the best form. And this is the best image. He standing upright, he's attractive, beautiful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given him the intellect. ثُمَّ رَدَدْنَاهُ أَسْفَلَ سَافِلِينَ. But he was heedless and he followed his desires and he was astray. So his destination will be hellfire. For those who denied, for those who disobeyed, for those who belied. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ فَلَهُمْ أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ. Except for those who believe and do righteous deeds. So they shall have a reward without end. أَجْرٌ غَيْرُ مَمْنُونَ. فَمَا يُكَذِّبُكَ بَعْدُ بِالدِّينِ. Then what causes you to deny Son of Adam? The one who created you will resurrect you. Why the belying? أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ. Isn't Allah the best of all judges? He doesn't oppress nor do any injustice to anyone. Allah, when we read this ayah, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِأَحْكَمِ الْحَاكِمِينَ, we answer, بَلَى. اللَّهُ أَحْكَمُ الْحَاكِمِينَ. Yes, Allah is the best of all judges. If we ask, how come Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the non-believers? So they are so rich, they are so happy, they are. We say that dunya is their paradise. So they will enjoy it. But they will be punished in the day after. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يُمْهِلْ وَلَا يُمْهِلْ. He gives chance, so if someone wants to repent, but he would never neglect anything. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best of all judges. Then in Surah Al-Alaq, we know that this is the beginning of this surah is the first that was revealed to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Sayyidina Muhammad, we know the story that when Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in Ghar Hira, Jibreel alayhi salam came to him. He got him and he said, اقرأ. And he said, ما أنا بقارئ, read, I'm not a reader. Then he took him and pressed him so severely until he was breathless. So this happened 3 times. And then he said, ما أقرأ, what would I read? He said, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. So this is the first that was revealed to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's an urge for us to read, to learn, to keep looking for the truth, to just to use our mind. Read in the name of your Lord who created. خلق الإنسان من علق. Created man from a clot. Created man from a clot and of blood. Then it turned to flesh. And then he made him a human being. Okay, I see someone is raising their hand, but I don't see. Yeah, okay. Now, اقرأ وربك الأكرم. Read. And your Lord is the most generous. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his generosity, he honored man with knowledge. So we have to spread this knowledge. الذي علم بالقلم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught man what he did not know. He taught by the pen. So the pen has no soul, yet it's capable of making people understand what each others write. This way we have books. We write our thoughts so others can read them and benefit from them. علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. He taught man, Allah taught man what he did not know. And this is why we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma allimna min ilmika al-ladunni, Ya Allah, teach us of your divine knowledge. Give us of your knowledge. Kalla inna al-insana layatgha. Nay, verily, man does transgress. So man behaves rebelliously. When he believes that, okay, I have money, I have people, I have children, I have everything, then he starts to go astray. And that's why bounties and ni'am is a test for al-insan, for the man. Will he thank Allah or will he just go astray? And ra'ahu istaghna, because he considers himself self-sufficient and has an abundance of wealth, honor, rank, children, he crosses boundaries of servitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah is saying, inna ila rabbika ruj'a, surely to your Lord is the return. This is a threat to man. He will hold man accountable to the wealth. Where did you get it from? How did you spend it? Man will be accountable for his deeds, whether good or evil. أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يَنْهَى عَبْدًا إِذَا صَلَّى. So, have you seen him who prevents a servant when he prays? Abu Jahl, the uncle of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to threaten Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you pray in front of here in the Kaaba, at the Kaaba, then I will step on your neck and he was a harsh man. He wanted to prevent Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from praying. So, أَرَأَيْتَ إِن كَانَ عَلَى الْهُدَى. But what happened once he promised Sayyidina Muhammad, if you pray, then I will do this. I will step on your neck. So when he saw that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is praying, so he went to torture him and he stopped as if he saw something, and he was going back very frightened and scared. And when Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, he said, there was a ditch, and had he come near me, the angels would have torn him. أَرَأَيْتَ إِن كَانَ عَلَى الْهُدَى. What do you think if this man is on the right path? أَوْ أَمَرَ بِالتَّقْوَى. Or if he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam orders people to be righteous. أَرَأَيْتَ إِن كَذَّبَ وَتَوَلَّى. So you, what do you think? This person belied and he went away. He turned away. أَلَمْ يَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَرَى. This is a threat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Does he not know that Allah sees him? That Allah will compensate him for what he is doing? Will punish him for his bad deeds? كَلَّا لَإِنْ لَمْ يَنْتَهِي لَنَسْفَعًا بِالنَّاصِيَةِ. Now if he doesn't cease, or if he doesn't stop, then we shall drag him by his forelock. ناصية كاذبة خاطئة, a lying sinful forehead. فليدعو نادية. Then let him call upon his council. Let him call his tribe, his people, everyone whom he used to be proud of. Let him call them. سندعو الزبانية. We will call out the guards of hellfire, the angel of torments. كَلَّا لَا تُطِعْهُ وَسْجُدْ وَقْتَرِبْ. No, Muhammad, don't obey him. Keep prostrating, keep getting nearer to Allah. Do not obey him in what he is forbidding you. Allah is going to protect you. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, so, كَلَّا لَا تُطِعْهُ وَسْجُدْ وَقْتَرِبْ. Do not obey him and fall prostrate and draw nearer to Allah. Sayyidina Muhammad says, أقرب ما يكون العبد من ربه وهو ساجد فأكثر الدعاء. The closest that a servant can be to his Lord is when he is in the state of prostration, in the state of sujood. Therefore, make abundant of supplication, make a lot of dua when you are making sujood. In Surah Al-Qadr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swearing, is telling us about the Quran, what happens. So Surah Al-Qadr, we all know Laylatul Qadr, and this is the night, a unique night of honor, dignity, glory. We spend it always with Quran and Salah, Salah. We spend it with prayer, with remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with dhikr. So in general, Ramadan is the month of spiritual training. Muslims strive harder in the last 10 days of Ramadan so to meet Laylatul Qadr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. So this is one of the merits of Laylatul Qadr, that the Quran descended down all at once in Laylatul Qadr. So we sent the Quran down in the night of Laylatul Qadr. And Sayyidina Aisha said, asked Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Rasulullah, ma aqulu fi laylatul qadr in araftuha. He says, what should I say in laylatul qadr if I know that this is the night of laylatul qadr? He says, say, Allahumma innaka afuwan tuhibbul afwa fa'fu anni. Oh Allah, you are forgiving and you love forgiveness, so forgive me. So this should be our dua in laylatul qadr. Ask Allah for forgiveness. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرَ. And what do you know of لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ? The word Al-Qadr means destiny. So it's the night in which Allah entrusts the decrees of destiny to the angels to be enforced. This is Al-Qadr. لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. The night of Al-Qadr is better in worship than 1,000 months. So the night of power, the night of Qadr, is better for you to live, to experience, and to enjoy more worship in it, the deeds, more than 1,000 months of your personal life. So this is 1,000 months is equals to 83 years of worship. Laylatul Qadr is more than that, is better than that. تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر. There in Laylatul Qadr descend the angels, ملائكة, الروح, جبريل عليه السلام, by their Lord's permission, with every matter. They come down with all that has been determined for the year that's coming. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إن الملائكة تلك الليلة في الأرض أكثر من عدد الحصن. The number of angels on earth at that night is more than the number of pebbles, if you can count. So what happens in ليلة القدر? In ليلة القدر, القرآن الكريم نزل من اللوح المحفوظ, from the preserved step, إلى السماء الدنيا دفعة واحدة. It was revealed to the lower sky just as one time, and then it began to be revealed to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam nujuman, which means five ayahs. Salamun hiya hatta matla' al-fajr. It's a peaceful night that extends till daybreak the next morning. So the angels give the greeting of the peace during Laylatul Qadr to the people in masajid, in mosques, who are spending it in ibadah, who are praying at home. So for the people who do Laylatul Qadr, who make the qiyam of Laylatul Qadr until the fajr. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Whoever stands in prayer, Laylatul Qadr, with faith and expecting reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will be forgiven for his previous sins. Subhanallah, Laylatul Qadr. Then we will go to Surah Al-Bayyinahh. We saw that in Surah Al-Alaq, Surah Al-Alaq contains the very first revelation, Iqra. Surah Al-Qadr shows when it was revealed in, we said, in Laylatul Qadr. The Quran was revealed in Laylatul Qadr. Then Surah Al-Teen shows where it was revealed, Mecca. And Surah Al-Bayyinahh explains here in this surah why it was necessary to send a messenger along with this holy book. So the surah talks about or shows the response of the people of the book to the Quran. What happened? We will read about it. We will explain this now. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لم يكن الذين كفروا والمشركين من أهل لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين منفكين حتى تأتيهم البينة. Those who disbelieve from among the people of the scripture and the idolaters, they will not change and correct their ways until they are presented with clear evidence. So حتى تأتيهم البينة, until they have the clear evidence. So what is البينة? البينة is رسول من الله يتلو صحفا مطهرة. So they will not desist from their unbelief until a clear evidence comes to them, which is سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, a messenger from Allah, reciting purified pages. فيها, and these are the pages of the Quran, to take them out from darkness into light. فيها كتب قيمة, wherein are upright books, which have no mistakes. The purified pages contain laws that are fair, that are just, that are balanced. فيها كتب قيمة. وما تفرق الذين أوتوا الكتاب إلا من بعد ما جاءتهم البينة. The people of the book, or the people of the scripture, did not divide into sects until after clear evidence was presented to them. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, all sects are going to be in fire except one. And they asked him, who are they, Ya Rasulullah? And he says, ما أنا عليه وأصحابي, what I and my companions are upon. So this is the right path. وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء. And the only command they were given was to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely and purely for Him and for Him alone. Their intentions in their worship is only for the sake of Allah, avoiding shirk, taking another God with Allah, and being truly devout to oneness, hunafa. So, not associating anything to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, anyone with Him. وَيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. So, and to perform salah, or to establish prayers. Look at the here that يُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ means they should be present. There should be presence in their prayer. وَيُؤْتُ الزَّكَاةِ, and they pay the zakah to purify their wealth. وَذَلِكَ دِينُ الْقَيِّمَةِ, and this is the right religion. This is the true religion, the straight and balanced, which leads to high heavens. So this is the religion that should be followed. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. أولئك هم شر البرية. Those who disbelieve from among the people of the scripture and the idolaters will be in hellfire forever. They are the worst of creatures. Their torment will not end, will not decrease, and it will not, and it will be eternal. Whereas the second part, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, as for those who believed and did righteous deeds, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ خَيْرُ الْبَرِيَّةِ. They are indeed the best of all creatures. And remember that, always remember that the word آمَنُ comes with عَمِلُ الصَّالِحَاتِ. So there should be belief and there should be good actions. Belief without good action is not enough. Good action without belief is not enough. Together, آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. So these are the best of people, the best of creatures. جَزَاؤُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ جَنَّاتُ عَدْنٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا أَبَدًا. Their reward with their Lord on the Day of Judgment is eternal gardens, eternal jannat, paradise, with rivers flowing underneath them. They will remain there forever. It will be eternal happiness for them. رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عن. Allah is well pleased with them. And they are well pleased with him for the reward that he has prepared for them. ذلك لمن خشي ربه. That is the reward for him, for who fears his Lord. The person who worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as if he sees Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At-Tustubi radiallahu anhu said, Allahu ma'i, Allahu naziri, Allahu shahidi. Allah is with me, Allah is looking over me, Allah is watching me. So when someone has the companionship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, then he will feel so bad to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Surah Al-Zalzalah, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we shall also find, so in this surah, we shall also find the earth talking on the Day of Judgment. So what will happen? إِذَا زُلْزِلَتِ الْأَرْضُ زِلْزَالَهَا وَأَخْرَجَتِ الْأَرْضُ أَثْقَالَهَا. So when the earth shakes and gets out all the burdens that are buried in, inside. So it throws all the dead people that are buried inside. So what will happen? Man will cry at that time. He will shout, what's going on? وَقَالَ الْإِنسَانُ مَا لَهَا. What's happening? So men will say, what's going on? What's the matter? Who are people who are casted out are stunned with what's going on. يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. So that day, the earth will declare its information. Each patch of earth where a person may have been wrong, may have done something wrong, it will testify on him. It will bear witness against that sinner. And the same, if someone is good, then that earth will witness on him. So يَوْمَئِذٍ تُحَدِّثُ أَخْبَارَهَا. It will speak of what people did upon its surface. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, do you know what is its information? فَإِنَّ أَخْبَارَهَا أَنْ تَشْهَدْ عَلَى كُلِّ عَبْدٍ وَأَمَا بِمَا عَمِلَ عَلَى ظَهْرِهَا أَنْ تَقُولَ عَمِلَ كَذَا وَكَذَا يَوْمَ كَذَا وَكَذَا فَهَذِهِ أَخْبَارُهَا. So verily, its info is the information is that it will testify against every male and female. بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا. And it will speak out because Allah commanded it to speak. يَوْمَئِذٍ يَصْدُرُ النَّاسُ أَشْتَاتًا لِيُرَوْا أَعْمَالَهُمْ. That day mankind, all people will split into two groups. They will split into groups to be shown the fruits of their labor. فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى. Whoever does the smallest act of good shall see it. وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَى. And whoever does the smallest act of evil will also see it. So Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, اتَّقُوا النَّارَ وَلَوْ بِشَقِّ تَمْرًا. Get away from fire. Fear fire even by giving half a date in charity. Or even by saying a single good word. And remember, don't ever say, oh, this is a small sin, it will be okay, I will do istighfar. No, just watch yourself. Watch whom did you disobey. لا تنظر إلى صغر المعصية بل انظر إلى من عصيت. So sins that are taken lightly, these are the sins that will destroy man. So this was Surah Al-Zalzalah. In Surah Al-Aadiyaat, I'm sorry, we are going a little bit. We have just a few more minutes to go. So in Surah Al-Aadiyaat, Allah subhanahu, we see that the surah starts with wa. Al-Aadiyaat are the running horses. This is what the word Al-Aadiyaat means. So the surah starts with wal-Aadiyaat, with a wow, then Allah is swearing. Let's see. Allah swears by the horses that run into the battles in his path. Fi sabilillah. They are fighting for the sake of Allah. And thus, when they run so, they are so speedy, so they run and pant. So this is, which is the babha, is the heavy breathing sound heard from the horse when it runs. فَالْمُورِيَاتِ قَدْحًا. So when they run so fast, they're striking sparks of fire from their hooves. فَالْمُغِيرَاتِ صُبْحًا. And scouring to raid at dawn. So the raid is carried out in the early morning time. Why? Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to perform his raids in the morning because he would wait. Did the people become Muslims? Is there the sound of Fajr Adhan? If not, then he will attack them. فَأَثَرْنَ بِهِ نَقْعَ. So when the horses run, the running causes clouds of dust. فَوَسَطْنَ بِهِ جَمْعَ. And penetrating the midst of the disbelieving enemy. So they are brave fighters on very strong horses. So Allah is swearing what? إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لِرَبِّهِ لَكَنُودٌ. So this is the subject of what is being sworn about. Verily, man is ungrateful to his Lord. Man is ungrateful for the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him. The word kanood is the one who counts the calamities and forgets Allah's favors. He always remembers the bad things that's happening. And he forgets to thank Allah for the good things that he has. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لِرَبِّهِ لَكَنُودٌ وَإِنَّهُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ لَشَهِيدٌ. And Allah so witnesses that man is ungrateful. Or man himself sometimes feels that, oh, what am I doing? So, وَإِنَّهُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ لَشَهِيدٌ وَإِنَّهُ لِحُبِّ الْخَيْرِ لَشَدِيدٌ. And indeed, man is extreme in his love of pleasures, of wealth, and of all good stuff. He spends time loving and collecting wealth and money. But أَفَلَا يَعْلَمُ إِذَا بُعْثِرَ مَا فِي الْقُبُورِ. Does he not know when what is in the graves is resurrected? أَفَلَا يَعْلَمُ إِذَا بُعْثِرَ مَا فِي الْقُبُورِ. The buried dead are being brought out. وَحُصِّلَ مَا فِي الْقُبُورِ. And what is in their heart is completely exposed. All their actions are made apparent. إِنَّ رَبَّهُمْ بِهِمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لَخَبِيرٌ. Verily, on that day, the Lord will be well acquainted with them. He knows all they did and said, and he will compensate them for it with the most deserving reward or the most deserving punishment. Surah Al-Qari'ah, the striking calamity. It's another name for the day of judgment, and it's also starts with a swear. Al-Qari'ah. Ma Al-Qari'ah? So what is Al-Qari'ah? What is the striking calamity? Would you know of that? يَوْمَ يَكُونُ النَّاسُ كَالْفَرَاشِ الْمَكْثُوثِ. It is the day when, mankind will be like moth scattered about. يَوْمَ تَرَوْنَهَا تَذْهَلُ كُلُّ مُرْضِعَةٍ عَمَّا أَرْضَعَتْ وَتَضَعُ كُلُّ ذَاتِ حَمْلٍ حَمْلَهَا وَتَرَى النَّاسَ سُكَارَ وَمَا هُمْ بِسُكَارَ وَلَكِنَّ عَذَابَ اللَّهِ شَدِيدٌ. This is Surah Al-Hajj. On the Day of Judgment, you will see that every nursing mother will be distracted from the child she was nursing. And every pregnant woman will abort her pregnancy. The people will appear intoxicated while they are not. But the punishment of Allah is severe. يَوْمَ يَكُونُ النَّاسُ كَالْفَرَاشِ الْمَكْثُوثِ وَتَكُونُ الْجِبَالُ كَالْعِهْنِ الْمَنْفُوشِ and the mountains will be like wool crated. They will fade, the mountains will fade anyway and they will be torn apart. فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about the two groups, those who are winners. فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُهُ. Then, as for him, whose good deeds balance will be heavy. Heavy with the good deeds. So his good deeds are more than his bad deeds. And he will have pleasant life in paradise. فهو في عيشة راضية. وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَفَّتْ مَوَازِينُهُ. But as for him, whose good deed balance will be light, so his bad deeds are more, فَأُمُّهُ هَاوِيَةٌ. So his forehead will be هَاوِيَةٌ. هَاوِيَةٌ is to fall into the depth. To fall from high to a depth is called هَاوِيَةٌ. So they will be thrown into hellfire. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَةٌ. And what is that? نَارٌ حَامِيَةٌ. It's a blazing fire, extremely heated fire. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the lightest person will have the lightest of the torment will be for a man who will have two sandals that will cause his brain to boil. So this is the bad torment that will be for the people of hellfire. And one day the hellfire complained to its Lord and said, "Oh Lord, some devour or demolish other parts of me." So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala permitted it to take two breaths, one breath in the winter and one breath in the summer, and thus the most severe cold that we experience in the winter is from the hellfire's cold, and the most severe heat that we experience in summer is from its heat. Allahumma ajirna min al-nar. Oh Allah, protect us. Ya arhamar rahimin, ya rabbal alameen. We ask you for forgiveness and we ask you to be pleased with us. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And sorry we took so long, a longer time today. Jazakumullahu khair for listening. Inshallah we will be meeting next time. Next week will be our last session, inshallah. We will finish till the end of the juzʼ, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.